We welcome all. Good to see each and every one who are here with us this morning. We do welcome you and hope that today's service will be a blessing to you, and that through it, you will be presented the gospel and the true meaning of Christmas as well. Let us begin with a word of prayer. Almighty God, we come before you in the name of Jesus. Lord Jesus, we come and we praise and glorify you. We honor you today, as we do every day. Today we come and we relate to people concerning your birth. And we thank you. We praise you. Be with each and every one that is here. May, again, you be glorified and honored. We ask it in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Come and behold him.
Morning, happy morning, Jesus, to thee be our glory again. Word of the Father, now in flesh appearing, oh come, let us adore him. Oh,
now Zacharias asked the angel, how can I be sure of this? I am an old man and my wife is well along in years. The angel answered, I am Gabriel. I stand in the presence of God, and I have been sent to speak to you to tell you this good news. And now you will be silent and not be able to speak until the day this happens, because you did not believe my words, which will come true at their proper time. Meanwhile, the people were waiting for Zechariah and wondering why he stayed so long in the temple. When he came out, he could not speak to them. They realized he had seen a vision in the temple, for he kept making signs to them, but remained unable to speak. When his time of service was completed, he returned home. After this, his wife Elizabeth became pregnant, and for 5 months remained in seclusion. The Lord has done this for me, she said. In these days, he has shown his favor and taken away my disgrace among the people.
In the sixth month, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you. Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will be with child and give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. His kingdom will never end. How will this be, Mary asked the angel, since I am a virgin? The angel answered, the Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age. And she, who was said to be barren, is in her sixth month. For nothing is impossible with God. I am the Lord's servant, Mary answered. May it be to me as you have said. Then the angel left her.
Turning to hymn number 86, the little town of Bethlehem.
The ever-blessed.
In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. And everyone went to his own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth to Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn.
And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over the flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly a great company of the heavenly host appeared to the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men of whom his favor rests."
Hymn number 85, the first Noel.
And fields as they lay, in a field somewhere, where a king may bear sheep.
When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about the child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just what they had been told.
He was disturbed, and all Jerusalem with him.
When he had called together all the people's chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where the Christ was to be born. In Bethlehem in Judea, they replied, for this is what the prophet has written. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For out of you will come a ruler who will be the shepherd of my people, Israel. Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, go make a careful search for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me, so that I too may go and worship him. After they had heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen in the east went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, and of incense, and of myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route.
Christ was born, all night divine.
When they had gone, an angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream. Get up, he said, take the child and his mother and escape to Egypt. Stay there until they tell you, for Herod is going to search for the child to kill him. So he got up, took the child and his mother during the night, and left for Egypt, where he stayed until the death of Herod. And so was fulfilled what the Lord had said through the prophet, out of Egypt I called my son. When Herod realized that he had been outwitted by the Magi, he was furious, and he gave orders to kill all the boys in Bethlehem and its vicinity who were 2 years old and under, in accordance with the time he had learned from the Magi. Then what was said through the prophet Jeremiah was fulfilled. A voice was heard in Ramah, weeping and great mourning, Rachel weeping for her children and refusing to be comforted because they are no more.
After Herod died, an angel of the Lord appeared in a dream to Joseph in Egypt and said, get up, take the child and his mother, and go to the land of Israel, for those who were trying to take the child's life are dead. So he got up, took the child and his mother, and went to the land of Israel. But when he heard that Archelaus was reigning in Judea in place of his father Herod, he was afraid to go there. Having been warned in a dream, he withdrew to the district of Galilee, and he went and lived in a town called Nazareth. So was fulfilled what was said through the prophets. He will be called a Nazarene.
Hymn number 87. 87, Joy to the World.
Thank you.
We thank you, Lord, for what you've done for us. And Father, we set aside this portion of time to receive an offering, Father, that helps to see that the message that we're putting here today goes out into the world. I pray that you'll bless this offering. See, Father, that it is used and it should be used under your leadership, under your direction. Thank you, lead, guide, and direct us. In thy son's name, amen.
And there was written a notice above him which read, "This is the King of the Jews." Now one of the criminals who hung there hurled insults at him. "Aren't you the Christ? Save yourself and us." But the other criminal rebuked him. "Don't you fear God," he said, "since you are under the same sentence. We are punished justly, for we are getting what our deeds deserve. But this man has done nothing wrong." Then he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." Jesus answered, "I tell you the truth, today you will be with me in paradise." What you have seen today is the gospel story. Jesus came and was born of a virgin. And he was born with God's intent plan, that he was to die for the sins of the world. Just as the angel told Joseph, he will die for the sins of his people, as he did tell Mary as well. Both knew what was to happen and what was to take place. Indeed, Jesus was born in the stable in the manger where there was no room. But later, he died on the cross. And that was the purpose and the plan of God, to die on the cross for our sins. That through him, there would be redemption. Through him, there would be eternal life. He came, not for himself, but for us. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one cometh unto the Father except through me. Understand, there is only one way to God. There is only one way to heaven. And that is only through Jesus the Christ. There is no other way. There are many people out there who try to tell you there are different ways and different means in which to get to God and get to heaven. But according to God's holy word, according to what is said in the Bible, there is only one way, and Jesus is that way. Remember, he said, I am the gate that you must go through. There is no other way. And so you can present it with the gospel. At this time, we will have an invitation hymn, 421, Al will come and lead us. If the Lord is working in your heart and your life today through presenting of music and words and everything, and if you feel that and Lord's telling you to come unto him and to give your life and your heart and your soul to him, you come as we sing hymn number 421.
Let's stand.
We thank the Lord for giving us this child. This baby was given to us by the grace of God and was sent to earth with a purpose. He was sent to teach his people that God loves us, and if we truly believe in him and live by his word, we can be assured a place in heaven with him. He traveled his country spreading his message for 33 years. The Jewish people became afraid because his message was different from theirs, and when he proclaimed himself as the Son of God, they had him arrested and sentenced to death. The Roman court had him crucified. He fulfilled the promise of God to save us from our sins. He had died on the cross. He rose from the grave and returned to his Father in heaven. We, as Christians, celebrate Christmas, the day of his coming, Good Friday, the day of his crucifixion, and finally Easter, the day he rose from the grave. We are so grateful to God for giving us this precious gift that keeps on giving in all of our lives.
Again, you have been presented with the gospel in fullness, the birth, and also at the end, the death of Jesus Christ. And understand that he did die for our sins, and on the third day he rose again, according to the scripture. Such an awesome thing. In him is the resurrection and the life. I'd ask at this time that you give a big round of hand applause to all of the young men and women. They all did a great bang-up job. I think they did really well with them, and I appreciate all that they have done. But also, I'd like you to give round hand of applause to also Debbie Garrett and also Colleen Armstrong and John Garrett. A lot just to go through all this. So I appreciate all that they have done, and also the ones who have put everything up, put things together towards making this complete and making this happening as well. Appreciate all the kids that came and all of you as well. We appreciate everyone who has come today. And I'd ask that during this time and also even afterwards, present this to people everywhere. Let them know that even in the face of disaster or no matter what they may be going through, there is hope. That hope is found in Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You know, I know we go through a lot, and there's lots of things that go on in our lives. Physical problems, turmoil, death, and so forth, and everything else. But understand that through Jesus Christ, there's always hope, there's always reason to smile, because it's not the end, but just the beginning. And I pray that we can convey this everywhere we go. I pray that you will also stay afterwards, and in the back we'll have fellowship. There's a lot of food, and I don't think Al and myself or Johnny Garrett and Danny Bryan, I don't think we can eat all of it. So there's a whole lot of food and a time of fellowship where we can all be in the back. So after they warm up and get everything all together in the back, we'll have a word of prayer in the back for the food. But at this time, we'll have a closing prayer. So let's all stand at this time. Almighty God, we thank you for all that you have done. We thank you that you came to be our Savior, that you came and your purpose was to die for our sin. We thank you. You were born of a virgin, walked among us, and then by your divine plan, you died for our sin. We thank you, we praise you, we glorify you. All that we have, all that we are, is because of you. We take no honor and no glory in anything, but all honor and glory be given to you. We are but your servants. And so, Lord, we just pray and we just thank you for all that you've done, and thank you for what was presented here. Indeed, marvelous at what you have done. Be with each and every one. Lead, God, and direct us forever and ever.
I pray that if God has spoken to you today, whether here or you looking at this on Facebook or YouTube, and if you need further counseling or if you would like to talk to someone and you live locally here, you can call at the church at 985-214-9343. And feel free to call, but if you're out of town or if you don't live near here, seek your local pastor or minister and talk to them further about your own eternal life. We only have today. So if you would like to seek or to talk to someone, feel free, call us and let us know if we can help you in your eternal life, your salvation, your relationship with the Lord as well.